Which BI tools are available in the market? What is the difference between Power BI and Tableau? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from Know-How Academy. In today's video, we are going to see what are the different BI tools available in the market, difference between the two popular data visualization tools, which are Tableau and Power BI. What exactly is Tableau and Power BI? Data visualization and its parameters based on which we will see the difference in between Tableau and Power BI, and what is the cost of Power BI and Tableau business intelligence tools. There are different business intelligence tools in the market like Power BI, Tableau, ClickView, Cognos, MicroStrategy, and more. But the leading BI tools in this modern tech world are Power BI and Tableau. So let's see the difference between these two business intelligence tools. Before that, let us understand what exactly is Tableau and what exactly is Power BI. Tableau is a data visualization tool which is used in industry. You can simply get the raw data and convert it into a very interesting, meaningful reports and dashboards. Tableau can be easily understandable by anyone. Even a person who do not have any programming knowledge can even create a customized dashboard in Tableau. It's very easy. Power BI, what exactly is Power BI? It is also a data visualization tool, or I can call it as a business intelligence tool, which extracts the data from different data sources and convert it into a meaningful reports and dashboards. Here we have seen what exactly is Tableau and what exactly is Power BI. Now let us see what is data visualization. Data visualization is nothing but we are representing the data in the form of charts, diagrams, graphs, a form of a pictorial representation. It allows for easy drag and drop functionality with the sidebar. Here in Power BI, it also offers the same features, like we can also drag and drop the columns and prepare a report. As we can see, I have a data set in this particular Power BI. The biggest advantage why Power BI is leading, as per even the Gartner survey also, Power BI is in the top ranking. Why is it in top ranking? Because Power BI has inbuilt data transformation feature, which we call it as a Power Query Editor. So once when we try to extract the data, so let me try to extract the data. Let me take a superstore data here. And here I have an option called as transform data. So here we have something called as transform data. So transform data is nothing but it is inbuilt transformation that we have it in Power BI. If you try to clean the data, if you try to see what are the errors, what are the empty informations, if any duplicate values are there, we can do these kind of transformations in Power BI, which is having an inbuilt technology called as Power Query Editor, which is inbuilt tool. But in Tableau, we don't have this inbuilt data transformation part. We need to choose some another software, do the transformation there, and again get it into Tableau. So on the other hand, that we have talking about the other business intelligence tool is Tableau. It is also purely based upon the visualizations, where it excels in creating visualizations in the form of worksheets or dashboards. So Tableau's versatility, it extends to handling the corrections across multiple data sources, and it accepts the advanced drill down features to enhance the data exploration. So in Power BI also, we have multiple data sources that we can extract the data into. If we see here, if we come into get data and click on more, we have multiple data sources that we can extract the data from. Either if you want to choose from any database, if you want to choose from any Power platform like Power Apps, Power Automate, if you would like to choose it from Azure, from cloud computing, from online services, it also extracts the multiple data sources. Let us look into the parameters. What kind of parameters do we have, and which suits best? So if you talk about the performance part for the Power BI and Tableau, in Tableau it can handle large amount of data, as we don't have the limit for the data to use in Tableau, but we have a data limit in Power BI. That is the only negativity that we can talk about, that we have it in Power BI. It cannot handle the data import mode on premises, which is 1 GB. If the data is greater than 1 GB, yes, obviously we have to choose for cloud storage or SQL server. We can go with the direct query mode. So In the next thing, if you would like to see, the data in Power BI has limited access to other servers and databases, whereas Tableau, it can extract the data from larger data set and other data sources like JSON file and so on. So the next aspect to consider is the learning difficulty. If you want to learn this Power BI, if you want to learn this Power Query Editor, it is very easy. Anyone can learn it when compared to Tableau. Whether viewed from a learner's perspective or a business perspective, Power BI stands user-friendly. So for example, I am from non-technical background. I want to learn Power BI and crack a job. So learning Power BI is very easy. Just you need to have a knowledge of a computer, and a knowledge of Excel will be an added one. You can easily learn Power BI. So when compared to Tableau, learning Power BI is very easy. As Power BI has multiple visuals, has multiple charts, we can see we have these many, more than 30 plus default charts. And if you go to custom visuals, we have 200 plus custom visuals in Power BI. So these kind of features are user friendly. You can just drag it and drop it. For example, if I would like to show it, I would like to choose this particular visual. And once if I get the data, I can drag and drop it and I can start preparing the visual. This is very easy in Power BI when compared to Tableau. On the contrary, Tableau operates on a columnar based structure, allowing for the storage of unique values for each column. This approach enables Tableau to handle large data sets, so fetching billions of records and so on. Then now comes to the point of integration. Integration in case of Power BI, you can easily integrate with different data sources. For example, if I go to get data, here even I can integrate the data from SharePoint. That is also allowed. If I would like to search for SharePoint, see, if you would like to get the data, integrate the data from a SharePoint perspective, Azure perspective, Excel apps 365 and many other Microsoft products. Whereas Tableau is used for scalable approach here with different data outsourcing tools, as well as including all these Microsoft based tools that we have it in Tableau. Now, when I have talked about integration, let us see the part about the data shaping. Power BI offers, as I told you, Power Query Editor, which allows its user to do many things in an easier manner. Let's consider in this Power Query Editor, I have some errors or I have some unwanted columns in my data and I would like to remove it. And it is very easy, it is user friendly, just right click and you can start removing it. You know, this is very easy in Power BI, it is more flexible. But when compared to Tableau, it does not offer these kind of services, which is a disadvantage in Tableau. The next top parameter that I'm talking about is the modeling. So in every business intelligence tool, we need to model the data. That is very important. Data modeling is very important. So Power BI provides Power Pivot, which are more accessible to the users, where Tableau, we do not have this Power Pivot kind of option. So that is the different parameters that we have when we start comparing between Power BI and Tableau. As I told you, we have many business intelligence tools in the market, such as Alteryx, you know, we have ClickView, we have Cognos, MicroStrategy, and so on. But in this modern tech world, there are comparisons between only two business intelligence tools, that is Power BI and Tableau. So as per the Gartner's recent survey, Power BI, which is a Microsoft product, it is standing on the top, and the next priority is Tableau. So the challenging business intelligence tool or the competitor to business intelligence, I can call it as Tableau. That's where we are discussing about the comparison between Power BI and Tableau. If I talk about the cost of Power BI and cost of Tableau, so Power BI emerges as a most cost-effective option in comparison to Tableau. So Power BI provides three subscriptions options that we have. So the one that you are seeing on the screen is Power BI desktop version, which is for free, that you can opt for it. And if you would like to have the services of Power BI service and custom visuals, if you would like to share the report or dashboard, we need to upgrade it to premium version or Pro version in Power BI. So the cost of Pro starts at $9.99 per user per month with a 60 days free trial version. So this subscription encompasses server cost, web user cost, and more. So on the other hand, if you talk about the premium plan, it starts at $20 per user per month, and it can go up to $4,995 per capacity. So when compared to Tableau, it offers creator, explorer, and viewer subscriptions with a 14 days free trial, only 14 days. When Power BI, it will give us a 60 days free trial version. Tableau, it will give us only for 14 days free trial version for users. So the creator plan is priced at $70 per user per month, while the explorer plan, it starts for $35 per user per month. And the Tableau viewer version, it costs at $12 per user per month. So it is very high when compared to Power BI. So analyzing the initial cost, Power BI stands out as the most budget-friendly choice, very easy to learn, very easily accessible, it is user-friendly and very interactive. So thank you for choosing Know-How Academy as your IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to us. It's been a pleasure interacting and sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.